This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. There are more than 750 dams around the country up for removal. Two of those dams are on the Elwha River in Washington State. Covering that story for months now as part of her beat is Katie Campbell. She is a reporter for EarthFix. That's the name of a local journalism center focused on the energy and the environment. She's based out of PBS station KCTS 9 in Seattle. This is a project from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. Katie, thanks for being with us.
Thank you, Hari.
All right, so you've been looking at several different angles of this for a while now, and literally you've got construction, or I should say deconstruction, happening on this river. First, why are we taking this dam down?
Well, there's a number of reasons why these two dams are coming down, but I think the main reason is that they're just old. These dams are around 100 years old, and they're just to the point of they're failing. They were slated for removal because they were failing, and if they were going to be updated, they would have to include fish passage because these dams were built illegally without fish passage in the early 1900s. And in order to build the fish passage into them, it was just going to cost way too much money.
This is supposed to be the world's largest dam removal project. Exactly how does that work? I mean, it's obviously holding a bunch of water back. What do they do?
Well, yeah, the largest dam is the upper dam, the Glines Canyon Dam. It's 210 feet tall, and it is holding back, the two dams together are holding back just a massive amount of sediment. It's I think we figured out it's 23 Empire State Buildings worth of sediment. So, yes, it's holding back a lot of water, but really the story is about the sediment, because that's been filling up behind these dams for almost 100 years now. And so what they're doing is that they're taking down the dams from the top, so notching it down from the top, and then letting the water down, and then they're going to notch it down some more, and then let the water out, then notch it down some more. That way they can really keep the amount of sediment at more of a manageable level for the river, so that it doesn't all come out in one big blow like they're doing with the Condit Dam down in southern Washington.
So for some of our landlocked viewers, what does fish passage mean and how crucial was it? I mean, we're talking about probably salmon, but how many salmon and how significant is that to the people that live upstream?
Well, the salmon runs on this river are legendary. They were up into the, like 400,000 is what they estimated the salmon runs were before these dams were put in there. And as soon as they were put in, there was just no more salmon. Behind the first 5 miles of the river. So they've been slowly depleting the salmon numbers over the last 100 years, and they're to the point of there's just a few thousand salmon returning to this river. Being able to join this team of folks from the local tribe and the hatchery and the national park, they were taking hatchery coho salmon upriver behind the first dam, and so this is a hatchery fish that was raised in a hatchery, but it's a species that is native to the Elwha River. So this team of people put little radio tags on these fish and then put them into this big truck to transport them, and then they had a fire chain of guys who were passing the fish from one person to the next and then actually dropping them in the river and taking them out of the bags and releasing them. And it was just neat to actually watch the fish and even get a fish's eye view with some of the footage that we got of having them. They were showing them this stretch of the river that their species hasn't seen in 100 years.
And what does this teach or show for some of the other dam removal processes that are going to happen around the country? Are other kind of land management authorities watching how they do it at the Elwha River?
There are a lot of people who are watching what happens here and watching for a number of reasons, because they're trying to find out what lessons we can learn from about dam removal and about taking down large dams. I think that even just the process of how it's done, how you manage the sediment, there's a lot to learn there. And there's, you know, scientists who are studying, they're seeing this as a huge science experiment. What happens to an ecosystem and when you take these giant structures out of it. And I think the other thing that they are learning from this is how successful can salmon restoration be. This project, what makes this one unique is that this watershed, 80% of it is within Olympic National Park. So it's protected, and it's in an ecosystem that is already really very pristine. And so if we can't get salmon coming back to this area by making all these efforts, if they can't do it here, then we're in bigger trouble than we even thought. So I think that's one of the big things that we're going to be watching for with this is how are the salmon going to do?
Katie Campbell, a reporter for EarthFic. That's the name of the local journalism center focused on the energy and environment based out of the PBS station KCTS 9 in Seattle. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Ari.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.